Hello and welcome to this online concert here from Évreux Cathedral in France from this fantastic Pascal Quarin instrument built in 2006. Tom, my brother's here filming and recording to bring you the great sound of this instrument. And we're here doing a piano and organ concert, but we couldn't resist bringing you some great French favourites, really. Of all the organ pieces that organists learn from the works of Bach and everything, the French organ music is the one that everyone really wants to play. Some amazing music, really impressive sounds, and they really just sound great on an instrument like this. Very sort of modern take on the typical 19th century French organ with this huge cylindrical case and wonderful doors and chamard reeds and a positive behind me. It's an amazing, amazing sound. And I've got some great pieces today. We began there with Guillaumont's Grand Coeur in the style of Handel, showing the full organ sound, really. And we're going to go straight on now to a piece by Theodore Dubois, Fiat Lux, taken from the opening of the Bible, the book of Genesis. Fiat Lux means let there be light, depicting creation. And so what Dubois does, he says at the beginning, no registrations. He just says start from the quietest stops and go to the loudest stops of the organ. So that's what we're going to do, a full demonstration from the quietest right to full organ. This is Fiat Lux by Theodore Dubois.
Thank you.
an amazing sound in here, absolutely deafening with that huge trumpet right above my head. So yeah, a really incredible way of showing off this instrument. And you'll have noticed that all the keyboards move quite a lot, and people noticed this the last time we were here, and it looks sort of quite heavy, and it is heavy in places, but it's due to a mechanism called a Barker machine, Barker levers. And what you do is you can play a note on one keyboard and it will pull down the other keyboard for you. And it doesn't weigh anything because it's a pneumatic action, invented in the 19th century by a man called Charles Barker, who's from Maidstone in Kent in England. He came to France, and Cavaillé, the great organ builder, used his idea. He was patented by Barker, so it's always been called a Barker machine. And on these stops here, it's still used today, and it says Barker on every single stop. An amazing thing, an amazing invention that this Englishman came to France and everybody used right to the present day. I'm going to use it again now in César Franck's Prelude, Fugue et Variation, written originally for harmonium and piano. A beautiful, beautiful solo line using the basson hautbois stop normally as a solo. We have the beautiful oboe here, which we'll be using as the solo line. A very sort of melancholy melody with a simple accompaniment. There's a fugal section in the middle, and then the opening theme reprises with a decorated arpeggiated version of the left-hand accompaniment. A really beautiful piece which makes the organ so expressive, even in such a big sort of mechanical instrument, you get this very beautiful musical sound. So I hope you enjoy this Prelude, Fugue et Variation by César Franck. As I mentioned at the beginning of that piece, the Englishman Barker came to France in the 19th century and was a great success with his mechanical invention. Another Englishman came to France as well, a chap called John Abbey, and he came over quite early in the 1830s and built lots of organs in France. He built for Reims, he built for Saint-Eustache in Paris, and also here for Évreux Cathedral. And the organ is the choir organ, and it's still here today. A small tube manual used to accompany the choir, built very early on in his career in the mid-19th century. It's original, it was rebuilt in the 1930s and reopened by Maurice Duruflet, so it has a great heritage and it's a beautiful sound, so I thought I'd play you a little demonstration of that with the next piece. I'm going to play a piece by Bonnet, Elves. Now this is from a collection of pieces again, but the reason I wanted to play it was because Bonnet was organist at Saint-Eustache in Paris and they also had a John Abbey organ. He had it for many years, so he would have known that instrument in the choir. And this piece fits perfectly because you can fit the registration on with the flutes and the strings, this sort of eerie sound. And we have this medieval parts of this cathedral with gargoyles and everything, and it just seemed like the perfect piece to play. So I hope you enjoy seeing this instrument, the John Abbey Choir Organ of Évreux Cathedral in Elves by Bonnet. A really nice thing to hear, that very sort of original 19th century sound. But the similarities between that and this are very, very noticeable. But another piece with that sort of very beautiful sort of semi-quaver figuration running through it is Gigoux's Toccata, one of the great French organ pieces. Gigoux was organist at Saint-Augustin in Paris for 62 years, a brilliant organist, but this I think is one of his really great pieces. It uses very simple toccata styles, really, a figuration in the manuals, and not even really a melody in the feet, it's just sort of a harmonic accompaniment, really. It builds up and builds up to full organ. You might say, there's no melody, it's just the sort of patterns, really. But it's a brilliant, brilliant, exciting effect, especially on the sounds of these reeds on this instrument. I hope you enjoy this. This is Gigoux's Toccata. Unusually today, we've had a lot of very original organ music, so I thought I'd include a transcription, a piece by Debussy, one of his preludes written in 1910, and this one is a really great piece of music, La Cathédrale Engloutée. The submerged cathedral, or the cathedral under the water, depending how you want to translate it, it's a very impressionist piece, really. It's sort of based on, possibly, the legend from the Breton myths, really, of the island of Ys off the coast of Brittany, a mythical place which was buried under the water. And it's said that on a sort of bright sort of spring morning, you can see the cathedral under the water. And what Debussy tried to do was to depict the sound of this sort of modal sound. It's almost like bubbles at the beginning, and then you get the sound of chants, plain song, and the high point of the piece with the bells is also the cathedral organ. Originally a piano piece, and trying to get all that sound out of a piano is a huge thing, so I thought we can have a real organ in a real cathedral. Not submerged, but very much a French cathedral with an amazing organ. And I thought this would be a great way of showing this instrument and a lot of the great, great colours on it. So this is La Cathédrale Engloutie by Debussy. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the online concert today here from this fantastic instrument. It's been a great pleasure to play for you, and thanks to Tom for filming and recording and showing you all the sights and sounds of this amazing place. I hope you get to come in and hear it in real life one day, because it's an incredible sound, very direct down the cathedral, but there's a wonderful, wonderful acoustic in here as well. And to finish with, I wanted to play a piece by Vidor, the first movement of his sixth symphony, one of the great sort of show pieces of the organ repertoire. It really shows off this instrument, but also what Vidor did. He's a great, great virtuoso. He was organist at Saint-Sulpice in Paris for 63 years, and pieces like this use all the techniques possible. There's octave jumps in the pedals, there's triplets against duplets, every manual is used, and sort of really virtuosic parts in the manuals, and all with these great, great French sounds which really, really bring it to life. So thank you for watching, thank you to Tom, and thank you to everyone at Évreux Cathedral for allowing us to make this for you today, and I hope you enjoy this. This is the first movement of Vidor's Symphony No. 6.